Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Gabby. I'm a New York City-based life and style content creator. I don't think I've mentioned on the channel yet, but I'm doing 75 Soft. So if you're not familiar with 75 Soft, essentially it is a 75-day health, wellness, and creativity challenge that has been circulating through the web, but I am doing 75 Soft, Gabby's version. And one of my challenges to myself is to upload a sit-down style video every Wednesday. So I figured a fun first video would just be my everyday makeup routine. This I do in like 10 minutes. It's very easy, very simple. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. I am definitely like a natural you but better type of makeup person, especially for daytime. And I like something that's very quick and easy to do. So yeah, let's go ahead and get into it. Cute. So we're gonna wanna start with clean, dry skin. For daytime, I always make sure that I've applied my moisturizer and my SPF because healthy, hydrated skin is gonna look so gorgeous, you know? The same thing goes for lips. I literally just use the very handy dandy Aquaphor. I have both like the stick version and then also the like kind of goopy Vaseline version, but I like to use this one before I do my makeup. So that's good. First thing I'm gonna do is prep the skin with a good primer. I'm actually a fan of a couple different ones. I really like the Laura Mercier hydrating primer, like the Milk Hydro Grip primer. But today I'm gonna use the Say Glowy Super Gel. This is in the shade Star Glow. I got this recently, but I've been using Sun Glow for the longest time. And I just apply this straight to the face. And I'm actually just gonna use my fingers, but I am in general a brush girly. I think that makeup put on with brushes, it ends up looking better, and it also just gets really even coverage, which is what we want. And I really like this because it's very light, but you can see almost immediately that it just gives my skin like a nice radiant finish. Gorgeous, stunning, beautiful. The next step in my routine is to apply some concealer. So I've been obsessed with the Fenty Beauty We're Even Hydrating Concealer. I'm in the shade 400 in. Apply just the tiniest amount of this into my inner corner and on the outside of my eye. I'm in general not a big complexion person for like day to day, but I do really like this concealer a lot. And I let that dry down. In the meantime, I'm gonna use the Milk Makeup Sculpt Stick in the shade Simmer. And I'm gonna apply just under my cheekbone at the perimeter of my face. This step is really gonna depend on your face shape. I'm a round face girly. So really just under cheekbone perimeter and then under here, chin. To blend out my contour, I like to use a flat angled, like dense brush. Any dense brush will do. And I find that this is just super easy to blend everything out. Just adds like a nice dimension, but also a little bit of warmth as well. That is contour all blended out. For blending out my concealer, I use a flat concealer brush. It fits really nicely into my under eye shade. This is the Pro Concealer 71 from Sephora Collection. And I literally just press into the product and just pat it under my eye. I like this concealer a lot. And this brush is like key. It makes it so easy. So that's really just gonna add like light and dark dimension to the face. All right, so now I'm gonna do my complexion product. For every day, I actually prefer to use a stick foundation. If I'm not using a stick foundation, I like using liquid foundations. I really like the Say Glowy Super Skin Foundation. That is my current favorite. But I'm actually gonna use a Lancome Tint Idole Foundation Stick. I'm in the shade 460 Suede Warm, and it just looks like this. I think foundation sticks in general are gonna be very popular this year. I've already seen a couple of brands drop new ones, so I'm really excited to see more on the market, but I do really love this one. And I tend to concentrate this on the cheek area because it's where I find I want the most coverage, but I also like to put it up here on the forehead and on the chin as well. I use the same brush for like everything. It's a dense, like kabuki style brush, which I really like. It works really well with like cream and liquid products, but I literally just blend that out by patting into the skin. And I love the finish of this. I think it's so nice. I've gotten literally so many compliments on this. It's insane and it's so easy. I love it. It's just, it's so good. But that is my foundation. Now we kind of get into the fun part. Now I'm gonna do eyeshadow. This is my simple, everyday. I don't have a lot of time, but I wanna do something cute and quick on the eye. Pretty much exclusively use the Not a Box of Chocolates palette. If you watch my TikToks, you know I use this literally all the time. I wish I could be more helpful, but these actually all fell out once, so they don't actually match. Like, when you buy it new, it's not gonna look like this, because all of these fell out, but I love this palette, it's so good. I'm gonna take probably the third lightest matte brown shade. This is what it looks like. And I'm going to just put that all over the lid. I actually really like applying eyeshadow. I think it just makes the whole look feel a little bit more complete without actually doing that much. And I'm using the Sigma E60. This is just a flat shading brush. This is just a very simple like shading brush. I just like it because it's quite large. It's like the entire size of my lid. And then I like to add just a little bit of dimension to the crease. So I'm gonna go in with this kind of warm reddish brown shade here. And I just go into the crease and I bring it all the way in, like almost like you're going to where your brow starts. And literally I just bring it in like that. And I think the matte shades on this palette are kind of really good. So I think for a drugstore palette, this is a really good one. And the most important step I find with eyeshadow looks is that you blend everything. This is the Sigma E40 blending brush. This is one of my favorite brushes. It's so good, and you're literally just gonna like blend everything out. So I used to be really bad about setting my foundation and makeup and stuff. I just felt like it always made me look a little dry. But your like 3 p.m., 4 p.m. self will thank you immensely if you actually set your makeup. I use the Laura Mercier Ultra Blur powder. It's cute, it has my name on it. And I literally just like tap some into the top. I wish I had a better brush to show you, but I literally use this janky, like kind of small, it's like the size of a fingertip, but it's literally just like a fluffy brush. I really need to get a better brush, but I just like stir it around to get it all over the brush, and then I concentrate it under my eye in that kind of shiny T-zone area. So up here on the forehead to anywhere where you get shiny is really where you want to be placing this. Now we've reached my favorite part. This is the, we're gonna do blush. I love the Sage blushes. Again, if you watch any of my previous content, you know that I love these. This is Chili. It is like a gorgeous, like, no, this is not what we want. This is actually what we want. This is Chili. It is a gorgeous color. I, for this, like to put it on the back of my hand because I just feel like it gives me a little bit more flexibility and freedom to place where I want to place. I recently have been using the Say Fluffy Brush. This is their blush brush that they recommend. They kindly gifted it to me and I'm obsessed with it, but you can also use any like dense foundation-esque like brush. For blush placement for me, I like to work it in this area up and then also kind of in. I like blush, so you gotta keep that in mind. So if you don't, the closer out that you do is probably better, but because I kind of like it to be prominent, I have a lot of like cheek space. Finishing touch that I love is just on the nose, on the bridge of the nose like that. That is all the blush that I'm gonna do today. To warm up the face, especially in winter when I'm not feeling super like warm and bronzy, I like to use the Say Sun Melt. I use the shade Deep Bronze, which is like a gorgeous like brown shade, and go into it and kind of go a little bit higher than where I put the contour. kind of directly onto my cheekbone and then around the perimeter again. I'm also gonna take this is technically a shadow brush, but it's kind of the perfect size for contouring your nose. So I'm gonna pat that into the product and I'm just gonna take it into the nose, going up the bridge and then down here, kind of in all the nose crevices. Okay, so now we're gonna do brows. Sometimes I do more on my brows, sometimes I do less, but for every day, I just kind of go for that laminated look. I'm gonna use the Benefit 24-hour brow setter. This is just in their clear shade. And I literally just comb out the brows and brush kind of in the direction that they would go in the eyebrow anyway. So straight up towards the end and then slightly angle it as you go through the whole brow. Whew. All right, at this point, I usually will spray my face. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray. I also am a big fan of the Urban Decay Setting Spray, but I got tricked into buying this by the Sephora Minis section. I literally just missed it all over my face. Now I'm going to do mascara. I like to curl my lashes. This is like an ancient Revlon eyelash curler. You can use any eyelash curler, it literally doesn't matter. And I'm gonna use the Fenty Beauty Hella Thick Mascara. This mascara is so good. I really like this mascara actually. I think it's pretty, it does a pretty good job on lengthening. The last thing that we need to do is lips. I like to, whatever shade my blush is, kind of go with something similar on the lips. Right now I have been loving Tower 28. Shout out Fenya for putting me onto this. This Milky Lip Jelly Gloss is perfection. It's so good. And the shade Sesame is like, just like the new, like it's just so gorgeous. I'll show you in a second. Okay, so that was my full everyday 10-minute makeup routine. It's super easy and the skin is skinning and we've got some color. Leave some comments down below if there's some sit down videos that you would like to see from me. And yeah, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I post every Sunday a new vlog, and then in the next 75 days, I'll be posting Wednesday uploads as well. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Have a great Wednesday. I will see you on Sunday. Bye.